Hello cyber citizens. Welcome to AVK classes. This is Fact or Science. In this section we explain the science behind mysteries, fiction, technology, etc. Before starting with the video. Here is Fact or Science question. Who coined the term personal computers? If you know the answer, well and good. If you don't, you will find out in this video. So stay tuned. And flex your brain muscles. Because we are going to get started. The first computer was made in the year 1949. Which was called ENIC. Electronic Numerical Integrator and Computer. It was so huge that it took an entire floor or two. And at the same time it was very slow and less powerful as compared to the modern day computers. But as the time went by, computers had become smaller and smarter. This reduction of size will continue. And soon the modern day computers will reach its physical limit. Here is where quantum computers come in. These computers will be extremely powerful. And will also help to create smaller and more powerful computers. Before understanding quantum computers, we should understand how a normal computer works. A computer consists of processor, which is called the brain of the computer performing various operations. Processor is made up of modules, which has logic gates. And logic gates consists of transistors. Transistors are much like a switch which allows the current to pass or not to pass. Over the years the size of transistors have shrunk drastically to 14 nanometers. Which is 8 times less than the size of HIV virus. And 500 times less than the size of RBCs. Due to this rapid shrinkage in size, one day transistors will reach the size of an atom. And if this happens, we will enter quantum realm. Where all the rules of physics will no longer apply. And rules of quantum physics will take over. Since the main purpose of transistor is to regulate the flow of current, which is nothing but the movement of electrons. But if the size of transistors shrink to atomic size, then they will no longer be able to hold off the moving electrons. Since electrons can easily phase through these barriers by the principle called as quantum tunneling effect. We have made a video explaining quantum tunneling effect. Please do have a look to get better understanding of quantum tunneling effect. So now due to quantum tunneling, the transistors will no longer serve its purpose. That's where quantum computers come in. Quantum computers will function on the principles of quantum mechanics, and thus creating the most powerful computer system ever imagined. Normal computers consist of bits, which is the smallest unit of information. Whereas quantum computers will have qubits. Bits are of two types. One stands for high charge. And zero stands for low charge. Qubits exists in a state of superposition. That means it is both one and zero at the same time. But when we measure a qubit, its value will collapse to a single value. Now superposition is a game changer. Consider a 4-bit information. It can take one of the following 16 combinations. Thus, using 4 bits, we can define only one of the 16 possibilities. But if you have 4 qubits instead of regular bits, we can have all the 16 possibilities at the same time. That means you can store a vast amount of information by just using fewer qubits. Also, qubits will have an amazing property of entanglement. In entanglement, qubits exist in pairs having close relation between the value carried by them. That means if we measure the value of a qubit, then we can simultaneously comment about the value of its entangled partner even without measuring it. We all know that a logic gate gets simple input in terms of bits and creates a definite output. A quantum gate will manipulate the input of superpositions and will produce desired superposition as its output. This will reduce the requirement of number of qubits for performing a particular set of operations. thus reducing the storage space and the time required for performing calculations. Quantum computers will not replace our normal PCs, but it would be of great help to the pharma companies in designing effective drugs. Testing all permutation and combination of chemical compositions to arrive at the most effective drug composition, all at a rapid pace. Quantum computers will have a computing speed that is square of the speed of modern day computers available today. Did you like the video? Hit the thumbs up button to let us know. If you have any comments, suggestions and ideas for future videos, please do comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to AVK Classes because we make videos every week. And please do press the bell icon to get notified whenever we post a new video. You can follow us on Twitter. Also like our Facebook page. All the links are provided below in the description. Thank you for watching. Now coming back to our facto science question. The answer is Ed Roberts. Ed Roberts coined the term personal computer in 1975 when he introduced the Altair 8800. Hope this video created a spark in your gray cells and helped you to understand the intricacies. We will meet again soon with another video. Till then, stay curious and keep learning. Thank you.